Hi, this is Zak Mir with the US penny stocks for Friday, the 17th of July here on Share Talk. And starting off with Allena Pharmaceuticals, you can see here we've had a bear trap gap reversal from the bottom of that trend channel from the beginning of February. Gap through the 50-day moving average was a nice sign in terms of the technical strength and the bear trap effect that the sellers have had, obviously. The view here is at least while we're above, we have an end of day close back above the 50-day moving average at $1.76. We have already hit that initial target at the 200-day line at $2.25. But the big target here over the next few weeks would be the top of that rising trend channel from February heading towards $3.75. This stage, generally back below the floor of the channel at $1.60, would really kill the recovery argument on this stock. Another new name for the penny stocks is AquaBounty. Here we've got beetle consolidation here, a little bull flag above old resistance, the old resistance being around $3.45. And while we're above that, on an end-of-day close basis, looking for further upside, we've got a line of resistance there from December around the 465 level. We could break that, though, and the best case scenario target here over the next 2 to 4 weeks would be the top of a rising trend channel from February as high as $6. So basically, this situation above $3.60 and that uptrend line from last month up to $6 as a best case scenario. Barnes & Noble is next. Covered this before with a little jibe about it being the new Amazon. Barnes & Noble, nice gap higher today. We've got the 200-day moving average falling at around the $2.90 level. And also that resistance at the top of the March channel at the same level. That's the initial target, but obviously if we can get through that and really snap the downtrend from the beginning of December, we could see much better prices, so worth watching out for that. At the moment, the stop loss, or what we wouldn't want to see really, is an end-of-day close back below the bottom of the gap there at basically $2.25. So that's the line in the sand for the bulls at the moment. New name again, coming through in the form of the next stock, which is Checkpoint Therapeutics. Obviously, pharma stocks and of all shapes and sizes on fire at the moment. Again, another bear trap gap reversal with the floor of the channel there and that uptrend line from March being broken, last week. But we've snapped back above that and the 50-day line at $1.98. And while we're above that particular number, looking for a top of November price channel target as high as $3.50, hopefully as high as the end of next month. Big plus point today would be if we can close above $2.30, which is the triple resistance of June. So that would be very encouraging. In fact, even better if it was $2.40 over. So that would crack the May resistance. But I think $2.30 would be enough, I think, to prove the metal of this situation. Otherwise, we'll probably have more consolidation between $2 and $2.40 in coming days. Another stock to keep an eye on over the near term is Capricor Therapeutics. Beautiful gap higher over the course of late April, and we've obviously retraced from that and taken up the slack. Good support there around the $4 level, and bounced off that this week again. Different ways of looking at it at the moment. I suppose one way would be to say that we've broken that line of resistance from May. And while we hold above it around $4.40, we're in a potential new leg to the upside. Otherwise, one would probably be looking for an end of day close above the 50-day moving average at $5.05 and to then carry the shares higher. Just how high we could go is suggested by the trend channel I'm just about to draw. I'm drawing at the moment. So that would take us hopefully to top of that channel, take us hopefully to $10 while we hold above the floor of the channel around $4.20 as the bigger picture call on these shares. But we'd like to see an end of day close at least above $5.05 to cement, or end of week close, in fact, to cement the recovery argument there. Another stock which is new to our sweep in the near term is ClearPoint Neuro. Here we've got gap higher today, breaking a line of resistance from back in February. top of the gap now and that line at $4, let's say $4 even. And an end of day close above May-June resistance at $4.60 should be enough to give us a retest of the best levels of the initial part of this year, as high as $6.30 plus. So basically here, at least while we're above 460, looking towards $6.30 on ClearPoint. Another new name as well, so it's, it keeps changing all the time, Edison Nation. Nice looking chart here in terms of the slow grind higher we've had since the beginning of June. Looking to retest that spike, that brief spike at $5.20 from April. But the overall picture here is that we're looking towards the top of a rising December trend channel to hit as high as $8. And that target valid by we hold above the late June resistance, which is effectively our neckline at the moment, around $3.50. So above $3.50, looking for $8 on Edison Nation. A stock which is also in focus at the moment as a potential bullish situation is PharmaSynthes. Here we had a break of the trend line there from April earlier in the week, and that was everything was really around the $6.55 level. Above that, we're looking for the upside. A good end of week close today above the 50-day moving average at $7.25 would cement the idea that we're going to head higher towards the top of a rising trend channel from the autumn of last year, or the fall, as they say in America, heading towards $11.15 at that price channel top. And again, a weekly close above that 50-day line, certainly helping the cause as far as this stock is concerned. Some resistance towards the $8 area, but even that would be a nice little win in the near term over the next couple of sessions, perhaps, for those who are long of this situation. Moving along to the next stock, and here we've got MicroVision, which has gapped up quite nicely today. Obviously, when stocks gap up so violently, it's difficult to get a handle on exactly where you should be, what you should be looking at, where you should be going. But the bottom of the gap there around the $2.40 level, so that's a potential entry point. Stop loss on the buy argument at the moment, the broken neckline resistance at $2. So a potential entry towards $2.40 if we pull back that far. And the stop loss on the buy argument around $2 and the floor of that rising trend channel from March. Best case scenario on the upside up to $5, which is the top of the March trend channel. And hopefully that would be hit as soon as the end of next month. Just three contenders to go now. The first of which is PhaseBio. Here we've had a gap higher above the 50-day moving average, which is normally a good and reliable signal. 50-day line currently at $4, let's call it $4.85. And while we're above that and above the and we have and above the floor of the gap rather, looking for a top of February price channel target as high as $7.50. Hopefully by the end of next month. We've got the 200-day line, the orange line there, also curving upwards now. So 50 and 200-day lines curving up in parallel, another leading indicator on potential upside. I covered this next stock before, I think just a couple of days ago, PDS Biotechnology. It looks like it's basically hit that initial target there, the top of the February price channel. $3.25, I think the high today, $3.36, so blink and you missed it, but we did hit that. End of day close above that line and above $3.36, and we could be looking for a new and better leg to the upside, hitting the top of that November price channel, the November resistance line projection at $6.50, let's say, and the upside target valid. We can make it quite tight, really, while we hold above $2.45, just below that initial July peak. So above $2.45, heading for a retest of $3.36 and then on to $6.50. Last stock of the day and last stock of the week is Unum Therapeutics. See the shares in this bull flag at the moment, bull flag well above former resistance, which is normally a good sign. So let's say the resistance there before between $2 and $2.50 from way back in August last year. The view at this stage is, at least while we're above the recent swing low at $2.70, we should see further upside and plan for further upside. That would be the August resistance line projection at $5. This stage only really back below that brief spike sub $2.50, really killing the bull argument at the moment. That's it from me this week. Joining me again next week.